Welcome. I'm your host, Robert Wilson with Cowboy Wisdom, Hypnoacuity, and Pure Liberation Television. I gave myself permission to rise out of my school years to set myself free. I now realize, and I admitted to myself, I encompassed a lot of scars from the school years when I was compared to other kids and what other kids said, my parents said. Anything that was said that was unsavory that left a scar in my subconscious. See, what we think consciously doesn't always occur subconsciously. The subconscious has a lot of emotions and feelings and descriptions and stuff that we've never expanded out of. And if you was like me, I wasn't the best kid in school. I was kind of ornery, mischievous, but I also wasn't book smart. See, school is for the book smart. Life is for the wisdom and the wise people that want to wander internally, setting everything free. And I now understand wisdom is the experiences and knowledge is the books. And that's where the world is today, stuck and hooked in books and afraid of the wisdom of the world. See, that's one thing I understand before technology. We had to have a lot of ingenuity, like working on the farm, driving tractors, things happen. You had to always be able to jury-rig things and make things work until you could get it to some place where you could repair it. Today, we do everything in the air, online, but we've lost the fix-it foresight in the world. We've become stuck in technology. But when I was in school, there was always the kids that always had it easy, it seemed like. I mean, school was easy for them. And not everybody's made for the scholar world. Some people are made for the craftsman universe. And that's where I was. And I really enjoy working with my hands. School books never enthused me. Now, I write them. Go figure. But no, really. And what I've understand is for like me, punctuated books and really books written by scholars are hard for me to read because there's no excitement in them. You take a Louis L'Amour Western, and that's good, but there's something I want to say. There's a lot of wisdom hidden inside the facts of fictional books because there's a lot of facts in them that we never know. But when you get into like reading a psychologist's punctuated book, I stop reading them because they never talk about one thing, and that's liberation. And they never talk about intuition. They always talk about, they're talking about how to stay inside. Like I read one, it was on regulation in the window of tolerance. All that is more limitations. But when I was in the school, I was always getting compared to the smart kids and always kind of, Trouble and me always have had a good relationship, but I'm okay with that. You know, Trouble is a trend-setting revolutionist opening unbelievable life events, boldly expanding through life, magically ascending, kinetically energizing, rebel-rousing riches to flow my way. See, that's the thing. We always want to be them 2D good shoes in the perfection programming, but it gets you nowhere. When the world rises out of turmoil, it's always done by troublemakers, rebellions, and things like that. It takes troublemakers to rise the world. And when the mundane mockery of the world you have today. So when I rise out of my school years, I opened up my sightseer's eyes to witness the world through my troublemaker wisdom. To understand, to rise out of the school system and societized ways and the business mindset of this world, which is an enslaving mindset, I rise of my miraculous internal nerve, dawning, sassy tenacity, to rise with spine-tingling, trend-setting audacity, to color the world my way. And as I open up to this and rise out of that and give myself permission to shed, shred it, and communicate away my school years, I set myself free. When you can communicate away and voice all the wanted, unwanted within you out, and voice in your inspiration, intuition, imagination, innovation, and unique talents. You rise to the sublime divine, riding on your superliminal carpet glide, magnetizing the world with your dreams and your desired lifestyle. Understanding life is awakenings and accomplishments. And see, that's the thing. We've always been trying to, we always are looking for solution and solutions and answers, and all we get is whatever our thinking, memory, mind tells us or what somebody else says. But when you ride of your intuitive glide, you galvanize lively imagination, dawning enterprising wizardry to listen to the universe streaming your liberating epiphanies as you stream your dreams through your intuition, imagination, innovation, and inspirations. You color the world with calm, balmy brilliance to realize within you is everything you desire and require to light your fire of desire, igniting your light of life to take flight. Feeling love, invigorate, galvanizing, hell raisers, trend-setting brilliance to rise from with you. You are the pot of gold at the end of the rainbow because you glow of genuine, liminal, optimistic wisdom because you rise above school years in a bold, bright way. And as you open up to understand what you was told in them classrooms, and if you was like me, the teacher always compared you to somebody else, and then you'd go home and then the parents would be waiting and they would kind of give you the what for, and they would kind of give you a nose spanking. That's where you kind of get your nose pulled out of joint. And then you'd carry that around and then you'd be ridiculed by it. Then that become a subconscious ingrained, frozen in time representation. The thing about it is you don't have to go into the trauma and drama and stress of it. You got to admit it's there, shed it, shred it, and communicate it away. When I say communicate it away, everything that's unsavory that happened in your life, go sit down or go out in someplace that's secluded on a windy day or by a river and just start saying what's inside yourself and just let it go. And you know, if a few unsavory words like you're scumming them out, come out, that's okay. If there's people involved in something else, when you're there and there's a big white cumulus cloud up there, put the person's face or send all your gunk up there. Just say, cloud, take it away, as I'm here to play in my fields of peace and prosperity my way. It's really about liberating you from you. Whatever happened in your childhood happened. It occurred. But there's no reason for carrying around. And when that's something, the reason I got out of self-help, personal growth, and self-improvement and reading psychology books and listening to psychologists, they never liberate you from you. They always say, I got therapy. And I also rose out of therapy to hypnoacuity. Hypnoacuity lights your light of life, letting you take flight because it calms the subconscious landscape and colors your dreams on your inner landscape. But see, when you can let go and communicate it away, it's a simple thing. I admit it to get rid of it. I appreciate it to get to listen to the value and the wisdom of the situation. It's now an awakening, chauffeur me on to my paths of enlightenment that throw me on my trails of triumph as I experience swinging in the hammock of bountiful bliss on my beaches of pristine serenity. I want to thank you. I am Robert A. Wilson with Cowboy Wisdom, Hypnoacuity, Pure Liberation Television. My website is mycowboywisdom.com and my email is mycowboywisdom@mycowboywisdom.com. I'm sorry, and you enjoy your day.